Hi YouTubers, it's your girl Elise coming at you guys again, and this time I'm coming at you with some of my favorite updos, 10 of them to be exact, and I'll be showing you step by step how to do each of them. Here are some of the things that you'll need. I have here one of those bendy clips that you can use to pin up your hair. You can get them anywhere from Walmart, beauty supply store, anywhere. I have one of these banana clips. It's made out of plastic. I like using those instead of the metal ones. And I also have one of these stretchy clips where you can get those from. You can get them from CVS. You can get them from Walmart. And basically, they just have clips on the outside and it's stretchy on the inside. I have an elastic band here that you'll need. A mirror to look at the back of your head with. And also a spray bottle to spritz your hair with water. So let's go ahead and get this tutorial started, shall we? So this is one of my favorite laziest pin-up styles that I just enjoy doing. I wear this style most of the time. People probably know me because of it. But basically, all that you have to do is take one side, pin it up with one of those plastic clips that I was telling you about, pin it to the back, check it out, then part your hair down. I like to keep my bangs out to cover my head. But take the other side, take just the same amount of hair, and pin that portion to the back as well. And, you know, that's, like I said, this is one of my favorite lazy styles when I don't feel like doing anything to my hair. This is all that I do, and it's really simple, it's really cute, and, you know, you can curl it in the front, do all that, looks cute. Check it out from the back. And that's style number one. Now style number two is also one of my all-time favorites. It's really simple to do. It's quite simple to the last style and the way that you part it. But you pretty much, whenever you see me walking out on the streets, I wear this style all the time. When I say all the time, it's also one of my second favorite laziest styles. So this is how it's done. You basically want to pin your bang section, if you're going to have a bang, to the front, and just start tucking and rolling your hair upward, tucking and rolling it upward into a French bun. And I've gotten really good at this because, you know, I do it so much, but it's really simple once you get the hang of it. It's just rolling. You're basically making one big flat twist up your head, up the back of your head. Also, be sure to check and make sure that everything is tucked in the back that you want tucked in. Because if you have any flyaways, it's gonna look pretty crazy. And usually I'll figure out something to do to the top to make it look right. That one just fell out. So I'll take my little clip here, clip it right at the top where I finished with my French roll. Make sure that I take out my bang, or else that'll look pretty crazy. And then just style it as so. It's really simple. It takes only a couple of minutes, and I'm out the door. And I also usually take one of those clips and just sort of pin up the little flyaways on the side, or you can take a bobby pin as well, so that, you know, no one will really see it as much as you can see the metal clip. But I just like to be a perfectionist. I like to pin up all the flyaways, and make sure that you check in the back just to look at everything and make sure that it turned out right. And that is style number two. Really simple, really chic, really cute. Now this third style is something that I just came up with last week when I was sort of playing around with this little clip. And as I said, I love my bangs. You can do this without a bang, it's optional, but I absolutely have to have a bang with whatever style I go for, because I have more volume at the top of my head than the back. So basically this style is kind of a fun ponytail, and you're going to, instead of putting a rubber band at the top, you're going to use that stretchy clip thing that I was showing you. You have to open it from the middle where the little stretchy part is in order to create a ponytail, and then you open it, wrap, well, put your hair through the middle of it. Make sure that the clips are straight. I made a mistake in the direction that the clip should go, but put your hair right through the middle of it. You clip one side of it into your hair, then you take the other clip and clip it through the other side. It's as simple as that. And my hair, it is a little stretched right now, so the top is looking a little crazy. So what I normally like to do whenever that is the case, I like to spritz some water to sort of make my hair shrink just a little bit. So I filled up my bottle with water, and I'm just gonna go through and spritz my hair. And throughout the course of maybe 20 minutes or so, my hair will go ahead and shrink back down, and it won't look as crazy as it's looking right now. But basically, that is look number 3. Take a look from the back. It's just a regular ponytail, really cute. Now with style number 4, I simply tweaked style number 3 into a different type of ponytail where I used an elastic band instead of the clip that I used earlier. And basically I'm just creating a little bun. I'm pulling my hair through only halfway to create the bun look, and I still have my bangs. Pulling up that little straggler, and that's style number 4. Now this 5th style is a little tricky. I've gotten to the point where I don't have to clip my hair up anymore at the top, but this one is a knotted style. It's a knotted updo, and you just want to take your hair row by row and create knots. Just tie your hair in a knot. And it's really simple once you get the hang of it and once you get the flow of things. But also be sure that you tuck in the hair that you left out from the previous knot. Make sure that you tuck it in underneath the knot right above it. So I'm just going up my head, making sure that I tuck each knot underneath the other. And it's really simple with Sisterlocks to part your rows because they are already very neatly parted. But yeah, so I'm just working my way up. It's getting a little harder at the top because my hair isn't quite long enough to stretch to the back of my head. So I just start tucking. I didn't really make a knot. So I didn't really make a knot at the top of my head. I just kind of tucked it into the previous knots. And then I kind of do something to the top and clip it in with one of those plastic clips that I was showing you earlier. And of course I leave my bang out all the time, every time. Take a look in the back, make sure that it turned out right. And that is style number 5. First of all, you need to know that I'm not the one. Think you getting something, baby, you ain't getting none. Now with style number 6, I sort of fast forward the video because it is a really simple style, and it is one of those lazy styles as well that I enjoy doing. So as I said, with Sisterlocks, it's really easy to just sort of expose your parts and part your hair. So I'm just putting half of my hair up and leaving the rest down. And of course, I have my bang. So I just take one of my elastics, wrap it around the top portion of my hair, pull it out a little bit, kind of leave it a little puffy. And check it out in the back. And that is style number 6. I always have a little straggler that gets on my nerves, so I had to pin it up. So I added style number 7 in for the ladies that don't necessarily like a bang look with their styles. So I did sort of like a pompadour ponytail look. I created a pompadour with the little plastic clip. And then I pulled my hair up into a ponytail again with the little stretchy clip. Again, I clipped it on one side and I clipped it on the other. And I also completed this style with water because my hair, as I said, it just looks crazy when it's stretched out and it's all over the place. So I just sprayed a little water to finish it off and to shrink my hair up a little bit and make it look right. And that is style number 7. Now style number 8 is just a style that I use to get the hair out of my face. It's extremely basic, but just use those plastic clips that I was telling you about earlier. Or you can also use any type of clip just to keep your hair out of your face. Just sort of pick it out and make sure it looks right. And that's style number 8, y'all. Now this 9th look is my all-time favorite look. I had to save it for last, pretty much. It's basically a faux hawk. You have to line it up with your neck. Be sure that you line it up with the center of your neck. And you just start pinning up. Pin upward. I usually use about 3 clips. And then go to the other side, start back in the middle of your neck, and start clipping upward. And I love this mohawk look. It's one of my favorite looks that I go for when I'm going to work. Sometimes I set off the alarm with the clip, so you can, if you're going through the airport, you can use bobby pins instead. Now I'm picking out my bang in the front, checking it out in the back. And that's look number 9. Now for this 10th and final look, I'm just showing you how you can use elastic bands to make a faux hawk instead of the clips that I was using earlier. So you just go along, collect hair as you go up the back of your head, being sure to keep it in line with the middle of your neck. Just go all the way up to the top. This one's probably a lot easier than the clips, but the clips look a lot cleaner in my opinion. But I'm checking the back, and that's look number 10, you guys. Now this last little part is just me wetting my hair, acting crazy, trying to spray it so that I can wear my hair straight. But I hope that you guys enjoyed my crazy tutorial. I hope you guys like this video and enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. And as always, it's your girl Elise signing out. Thanks for watching, you guys, and have a blessed day.